Hello, I'm Dr. Roshit. Welcome back to Happy Guru. Before getting to today's talk, as usual, I will discuss a quote which will be a preface to that. This is a verse from Bible and a very common one. It says, "You reap what you sow. You face the consequences of your own actions, be it good or bad." This is also called law of reciprocity. Today's topic is, what is the connection between Newton's third law and karma? First of all, what is Newton's third law? It says, every action has an equal and opposite reaction. What does that really mean? In the physics of motion, it means that every action, there is an equal and opposite force acting upon the object, which will move the object forward. Classic examples are, you're walking. You exert a force on the ground, which will in turn create a force within the ground, which will push you forward. Likewise, rowing a boat. You exert pressure on the water with paddle, which in turn create a force within the water to push the boat forward. But what is the ironical meaning of this law? For me, it is same as karma in Hinduism and Buddhism. What is karma then? In simple words, karma means life is like a boomerang. What you give, you get it back. There are a few principles in karma, which I would like to compare a farmer as an example for these principles. First one, the farmer sows one seed and in return he receives many folds back. In karma, it's exactly the same thing. You do a good deed, you receive it back in many folds. Second one is patience. Farmer sows the seed now and he harvests it many months later. You have to wait months to reap the reward. Same in karma, you cannot expect the result happening straight away. You keep doing good deeds and you can only reap the rewards in the many months and years to come. Third one, if the farmer is hit with a drought and he could not harvest in few years in a row, he still keeps sowing the seeds, no matter what. Same in karma, you have to keep doing good deeds to reap the rewards later. You may feel it's not reaping the rewards as you expected, but it will surely happen one day. Fourth one is a principle that is nothing connected to a farmer, but it says, you do a help to someone, you may not receive that help back from the same person, but you will receive it back for sure from someone else or some other source. So karma is whatever you do, you receive it back. You give money to help someone, you will receive it back in thousandfold. When you give love, you receive more than you give. You spread bad thoughts, you receive bad thoughts. You do bad things, you receive bad things. So you are solely responsible for what's happening in your life. Nothing happens by chance or by fate. You create your own fate by your own actions. That's karma. All the good and bad things happening in your life is due to your own actions, nobody else's. So you cannot blame anyone else for bad things happening in your life. You attracted good things into your life because of your good deeds, because of your good actions, because of your good thoughts. So if you want good things happening in your life, you should start doing good things in your life. Start helping others. Be happy all the time. You will get more in return from other sources and you will be receiving more happiness in life. So if you want more money, what do you need to do now? You must give more money to help others. Never wait till you have enough money to offer help. So let me tell you a small story regarding this. Bill Gates, when he was the richest man on the planet, was asked by someone, "Is there anyone richer than you in the world?" Bill Gates replied, "Yes, there is a man richer than me." So he told about a story of his own life when he was not rich or famous. He was at the New York airport and went to the newspaper vendor to buy a newspaper, but he realized that he didn't have enough change. So he returned the newspaper to the vendor and said to him that he don't want it because he don't have enough change to buy it. The vendor offered the newspaper for free and Bill Gates kindly took it. Same thing happened after a few months. In the same airport, he didn't have enough change for the newspaper. The vendor offered the newspaper free again. When Bill Gates refused to take it for free, vendor said that he was sharing it from his profit and won't be in a loss. Bill Gates took the newspaper. After several years, when Bill Gates became millionaire and famous, he searched for this vendor and finally found him. When he asked him, did he recognize him? The vendor said, "Yes, you are Bill Gates." Bill Gates then asked him if he remembers him giving a newspaper for free. He said, "Yes, of course I do. I gave you twice." Bill Gates wanted to repay the help he had offered and requested him to ask him whatever he wants in his life. He was happy to fulfill it. The vendor then asked him, "So do you think that by doing so, will you be able to match my help? When asked why, Vendor replied, I had helped you when I was a poor newspaper vendor and shared my little profit with you. You're trying to helping me now when you are the richest person in the world. How can your help match mine? That day, Bill Gates actually realized the newspaper vendor is richer than him because he didn't wait to become rich to help someone. So the lesson we all need to learn from this story is that truly rich are those who possess a rich heart rather than lots of money. Being kind and helping others selflessly make you the richest person in happiness. So today's lesson is to give whatever your situation is, then there will be an opposite reaction or a karma that will make you wealthier and more happier. Verses from Bible, Quran, Bhagavad Gita, law of motion of physics, everything says exactly the same. All that teaches you to be grateful for what we have. Give more to help others and then wealth and happiness will come in search of you. Your greatness is not defined in what you have. It's in what you give. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to sign off today with a quote by Oprah Winfrey, which summarizes every law we discussed today. Law of reciprocity, law of motion, karma, everything. She says, to move forward, you have to give back. Thanks a lot for listening. Until I see you next time with yet another motivational video. Goodbye.